So far we have discussed about certain types of automata, particularly finite automata and its variants, deterministic finite automata, non-deterministic finite automata, etc., and Pushdown automata. And we have observed that these automata have certain limitations, and we have identified that there are certain languages which are not accepted by these automata. Particularly, if I, as an example, you consider this a power n, b power n, c power n, such that say n greater than or equal to 1. Or, so, this language we understood that it is not context free, and there is no Pushdown automaton accepting that. And in the usual computation using your routine computer, it is very clear that there are much more complicated languages than this particular example. You can compute it and see that the computer is handling such languages all that. Now, when one thinks for modeling this computation or the notion of algorithm, essentially, you know, this type of automata so far we have introduced are very restricted, and one looks forward for a better model which can accept much more complicated languages than whatever so far we have seen through this Pushdown automata or finite automata. So, in that direction, in this lecture we discuss about an automaton so called Turing machine. This is named after Alan Turing, mathematician. So, it is called Turing machines. In this lecture, and we understand that these are having enough computational facilities, and indeed that this is this will work for modeling the computation. And this Turing machine, as having the features of an automaton, there will be a tape, finite control, and all those things. Here is a very important point that in case of finite automaton, we have a left justified right side infinite tape and a finite control. So, we are taking symbols, the input from the tape, and with respect to the internal state, what are the transition is given accordingly, it will take the transitions, and finally, if it is reaching to a final state, we are saying it is the input is accepted, otherwise rejected. That is how in finite automaton we have followed, and we have certain variants class of languages accepted by deterministic finite automata or finite automaton. There is a regular languages, that is, you know, we have discussed about 2DFA, that is, you are allowed to move this reading head not only to right, maybe left. That way we have discussed 2DFA, and it is not having much computational power than a typical deterministic finite automaton DFA. So, essentially the class of language accepted 2DFA is same as regular languages, although you are allowed to move it. And we have discussed machines which give output, there you have an output tape, and you are allowed to print some symbols on this corresponding to each symbol there, Moore Milley sort of machines we have discussed. And we see that this type of machines are also very restrictive to handle some complicated languages or to give certain outputs as per the requirement. Now, in case of Pushdown automata, we have a stack. Okay, let me call for example a Pushdown stack sort of, we have discussed in case of Pushdown automaton, there is a stack, and in which case we have things like this. And now, what are the symbol that you are reading corresponding to that, you may push something, some information into the stack and read using stack principle on this, and so on. Now, in case of Turing machine, the situation is if you are allowed to write, I mean printing the symbol, and allowed to move both left and right, in which case we actually introduce the concept called Turing machine. We introduce this concept called Turing machine, and a Turing machine is the utmost powerful device for the computation. In fact, whatever that you can do using a routine computer, that you can do using this Turing machine, such a powerful this thing. Only two things, extensions for a DFA, that we can clearly see that you are allowed to print on the tape, and number two, you are allowed to move left and right. So, with these two, we will gain the ultimate power to represent computation. It means whatever we can do with the routine computation in computer, that you can do it using Turing machine. Now, informally, the things is like this: a left justified right side infinite tape, and the tape is divided into cells. Now, here this is not only reading head, in case of DFA, this is reading and writing head. Reading and writing head, and you have finite control, certain states, say Q0, Q1, and so on, and the pointer pointing to this. Now, the transitions are something like this. Given a state and a symbol, you are allowed to print also, or you are allowed to move not only to right, you can move one cell to left also. So, this kind of thing is allowed in case of this Turing machine. So, with this we will get the ultimate power, as I had mentioned. Now, let me give you a formal definition for this. The definition of Turing machine. As earlier, you require a set of states and certain symbols that you will put it on the tape. And here, in contrast to the DFA, here we designate one particular special symbol, that is like final state, we call it as halting state, that once you reach to that particular halting state, you will not have any further computation. That means, there no transition is defined. So, you will reach there and you will stop the computation there. That is how one special state is introduced, and once you give the input on, in case of DFA, on the tape. And after that, you see this is a right just left justified right side infinite tape. There are several cells. For example, if I give the input A B, now these are all the cells which are available. And in case of DFA, we simply go till the end of the input and we stop it there, the computation. This is what automaton automatically stops over there. Since you are allowed to go left and right and you have that facility. Now, once you reach to this, if you want to go further and if you have the situation to come back and read the input and what are the changes that you do in the input. So, based on that this input, for example, here there are 5 symbols, since you are allowed to write, you may go and at the end you may print something and you may go further and print something, so that you can always do such modifications. And therefore, you are visiting these cells which are blank, where you are not giving the input. So, this blank cell we may represent with the symbol this hash. So, we include a special symbol when we are talking about input, this special symbol will also be considered. So, now there are two things, one for the final state, or I call it as halting state, the computation when the machine halts, such a state is called halting state, the machine comes to that particular state, and after that there we do not define any transitions. And this new special symbol for the in case of input that we are considering is blank, to represent the blank cells on the tape. So, So, these are the two important new things that we have not so far discussed. So, this Turing machine, we introduce it as a quadruple. The quadruple, there are four components. Let me write q sigma delta q naught. As you know, q we normally write for the states, q is a finite set of states, and here we assume that this symbol h, this is writing for halting state, this is not in q, this is we write for halting state. So, this is one, and sigma is again a finite set, this is the alphabet from which you give some input, and what are the symbols that you want to type. So, all these symbols should be available here, this is a finite set, this include this particular symbol hash, so including this symbol. But of course, here now moving left and right, because in case of DFA or finite automaton, what is the situation there? Automatically the reading and writing head in a particular transition takes a right move, and in case of 2DFA, if you remember, we have defined this as define in the transition, we are defining it whether it has to move to left or it has to move to right, we are defining it. So, here also we have to define. So, those symbols we assume that they are not part of this sigma. So, further you assume that the symbols L and R, which are indicate which we are using for the reading head to move to right or left, they are not elements of sigma. So, this care you take. So, blank symbol has to be there in sigma, this is representing blank cell on the tape. So, this will be there, and now as usual q naught, this is a state for the initial state, is the initial state. This is the initial state. Now, let us look at transitions. As we have discussed, given a symbol and a state, you may be allowed to print in the particular cell, or you may be allowed to now move left right. So, these are the possibilities that we have discussed. So, I give you delta the transition function, given a state and a symbol of sigma. Of course, you change the state, it can be halting state, you may finally halt after reaching to this state. So, this h is not part of q. So, there are no further transitions defined for this, because delta we are defining from q cross sigma, h is not in q. Once you reach to the halting state, then we do not have further definition. So, that is how we have taken care here, this is a function from q cross sigma, but you may have in a particular transition you may reach to this state. So, a state component is this, and you may print, in which case that is an element of sigma, or you may move to left, so that is L, or you may move to right. So, a function called transition function, this is the transition function. Of the Turing machine. So, this is the quadruple. So, you take a finite set of states, you take some alphabet from which you may give the input, and the symbols from which you may print on the tape, and so on, and now blank symbol has to be there in that, and a halting state is not part of the state set, q naught is the designated initial state, and the transition function from this set q cross sigma to the set q union singleton h cross sigma union L r, the meaning of this I have mentioned. That is, if you take the element of sigma, in which case in that particular transition you have to print some symbol on the tape, and if it is L, if you are assigning L, that means the you are asked to move the reading and writing head to reading and writing head one cell to its left. If it is R, it is asked to go to right one cell. This is the transition map. Now, let us look at some example. Just for the sake of simplicity, let me take it this way. Q, just one state, because I want initial state, and sigma, say A, B, the blank symbol has to be there, and I designate Q naught as initial state, because there is only one state here, and now I define it like this. So, for the symbol A, the symbol B blank in the initial state, if I am reading, I will change the state to Q naught, continue in the same state and go to left. If I encounter this B, is only one state, I encounter this, and when I am reading this, I will halt and say take a right move. Or let me give it this way, print blank. So, suppose if I define transition map like this, because there is a state Q naught A B blank for these symbols I have defined. Now, by definition Q sigma, this delta and the initial Q naught is a Turing machine. Likewise, you know, you take a finite set of states and some alphabet, and for every state and a symbol you give some transition here. That means a state, either you ask it to move to left or maybe move to right. Okay, let me choose, for example, maybe here right, so that you have all the things represented. So, move to right, or you print. Here I am printing blank. So, likewise you define, and you see by definition this quadruple is a Turing machine. Now, what is the behavior of this Turing machine? What type of jobs like that you can pursue, and all those things, that first we have to talk about the language acceptance and all those things. Now, in case of DFA or push down automaton, you have understood that this is, that is defined as a language acceptor. As I had mentioned some time back, that these Turing machines will be shown as ultimate computational device, that means the utmost powerful device for computation. Because in case of computation, it is not only the language acceptance, it is not only the language parsing, it is that you may be given some input and you may expect some output in your program, in your algorithm. So, that kind of computation we do. So, here we have the facility of writing on the tape. So, this Turing machine will be introduced is not only as a language acceptor, but also to see like Moore and Milley machines, like Moore and Milley machines are to give some output, give some input and expect some output on the tape. So, this kind of computation that we will pursue with this Turing machine. Anyway, since we are already familiar with the language acceptance part, that means given a string on the tape with the initial state, this is an automaton, it takes the transitions automatically, and it will finally come, if it is finally coming to the final state by the time of you know this transitions after completing that input. But here the situation is, you are allowed to move to left, right, all the directions. So, it is not like completing the input. In case of finite automata or push down automata, you see that the reading and writing head on the tape is moving only one direction, and end of the input, if you see the state is final state, you are saying it is accepted. But in case of Turing machine, we are allowed to move it to both left and right. Now, you see when you are going to finish, or you know, and more tricky thing here is you are allowed to print also. Whatever the input is given, end of the thing, you may go and print some more. So, it is maybe part of input or something newly you have printed. So, there is nothing like you know completing the input here. So, this is an automaton, transitions takes place instantaneously, it will not take any time. So, in the initial state you start the machine during machine and see eventually, that means eventually if it is coming to the halting state, that is the final state as I had mentioned, if it is coming to a halting state, we define the notion like the input is accepted, whatever the changes it is doing, let it do. It may print certain symbols, it may erase certain symbols, it may print some symbols and so on, but eventually if it comes to the halting state, we say that the input is accepted. And when we are expecting some output on the tape, we will expect that this particular output need to be printed and eventually it has to halt. Because once again I emphasize the point that this is an automaton, each transition takes instantaneously, even if it is 100 transitions or 1 crore transitions, whatever, the total time it takes is zero time. That means, instantaneously you give the input and eventually, that means immediately right after pursuing that, it will, if it is halting, it will come to the halt state with zero time, or you know, if it is not halting, it will go to some sort of infinite loop, one can say. So, that kind of situation that you will see with the Turing machine. Now, how do we give the input and all those things we will discuss some, and we fix some pattern here, and accordingly I will define the formal notions based on that. So, I fix this notation that for the Turing machine, of course, there is a left justified right side infinite tape divided into cells. I always give the input by leaving one cell in the beginning. You will understand that why I am leaving this. So, this is a blank cell. So, I am representing it, and the input whatever is that x may be a b, whatever. So, I give the input like this and we start the computation from the rightmost side of this. So, the writing head initially will be here, and we set the state to the initial state, that is how it starts. This is the convention we follow. And now, as per the transitions of the finite control, the automaton works, and eventually if the pointer shows the halting state, if it shows the halting state, then I say the input is accepted. This we formalize. So, this notion I will formalize it here. So, as in case of finite automaton or push down automaton, given a particular situation, that is so called instantaneous description or configuration we call, configuration or instantaneous description, this is what the word we are using, instantaneous description. So, that means, at a given point of time, what is there on the tape, what is the current state, where is the reading and writing head. So, this particular picture need to be represented. So, this is called configuration. So, the initial configuration, that means, how we are starting, you are having blank on the tape and whatever is the input x is given, and the reading and writing head is here on the tape. And whatever is the current state, that is, so this particular picture, I need not draw the tape and whatever this reading and writing head and the finite control and all that. This is the information that I am seeing on the tape with x is equal to a b, here x is equal to a b. So, this is the information, if I somehow mention, then I know how to draw this diagram. For a given point of time, say for example, reading and writing head is pointing this particular b. And say for example, state is say for example, Q5. We know that by just mentioning what is the tape content and where is the reading and writing head and what is the current state, if I give this, I can always draw this picture. So, that is what the notion of instantaneous description or configuration, you know already in case of finite automaton and the other places we have discussed. So, this instantaneous description or configuration, we define it formally. That is, the current state we have to mention, it is a state component, and you see from the reading and writing head, the left side to this, there will be some tape content, this is a left justified tape. So, the finite amount of information will be here, that is the maximum because this is a left justified tape. So, this is an element of sigma star, it is a combination of symbols of elements of sigma. So, the left to the reading head is an element of sigma star and the reading head always points out some symbol of sigma. And then when you see right, I cannot say that is just a element of sigma star. The reason is I am interested about the input, what is there on this. There are infinitely many blank cells on this side, on the right side, because it is right side infinite tape, and therefore, I have to take care of this situation. That is, I cannot simply write sigma star here, because right to the current particular symbol, it is an element of sigma star, because blank is an element of sigma, and therefore, writing sigma star means so many blanks which I am not interested in. Unless the reading and writing head is on a blank cell, I am not going to look at this. So, till this we write. So, we restrict writing leading blanks here on the right side in a given string. So, how does that set, how it can be represented? That is an element of sigma star, and at the end I have to remove this blank, that means sigma minus this blank. So, all those strings which are not ending in blank are represented like this, and of course, if you are at the end of this, I have only blanks here, since we have restricted that. So, for example, if this is the situation, here are all blanks, that means empty string is here. So, that has gone here, because I have concatenated this set with this. So, I include that separately. So, this is epsilon. So, configuration or instantaneous description is an element of this set. When the state component you declare, what is left side to the current symbol and what is the current symbol, and what is the right side to the current symbol, this is to be declared. For example, in this particular situation, I have these two descriptions. In case of the first one, Q naught blank, we have written ABB. So, this blank ABB, this is the string, and the current symbol is blank, and right side to that is epsilon. This is the configuration in this picture, or as I had mentioned second time, that is Q phi is the current state as I have mentioned, and left side to the current symbol is A blank AB, and the current symbol is B, and right side to this AB. Now, you see this of course, assuming this, I do not have this to point out. So, there are several blanks, of course, we are not going to write that, only the part of sigma star excluding means which is not ending in blank. So, this is the second one. So, these are the configurations in that representing that particular these pictures whatever I have drawn here. So, this is how the configurations are formally defined. Now, what I follow is whenever the input is given on the tape, I leave one blank here and the input will be given, and I start from the right side of the input. You will understand why I am normally so far in the finite automaton, because the convention is we are always moving to right in case of push down automaton also, but here since we are allowed to both move left and right for some reasons that you will realize little later after few lectures, that I always start from the right side of the tape. I do not have any problem, because I am allowed to move left and right. So, I can always go to left and read this input. So, I start from the right side of the input, that means this particular blank from here I will start. This is the convention we follow, and then of course, we have to start with the initial state. Now, let me give some abbreviation here. So, instead of writing 1, 2, 3, 4 components like this, just by distinguishing where is the reading and writing head, I can always simply write this as, say, state component, let me write like this, and this I will write it as blank ABB AB blank, and the current symbol is this. I will represent this by underscore. So, this is the shorthand that I use for this, you know, instead of writing this many components. Similarly, for this, using that notation, I may simply write it as Q phi blank A B B A B. This is how I will write. I mean, by giving the underscore at a particular symbol, the reading and writing at this particular symbol, that is the meaning. Now, I give some more notations here. As I had mentioned, the initial configuration is of, if Q naught is the initial state, it is of the form blank x blank, here we start, when x is the input and Q naught is the initial state. This is the initial configuration. Any Turing machine I start with this configuration. And now, final configuration, if exists, final configuration. That means, given an input, on that particular input the machine may halt or may not halt. Whenever it is halting, you get the final configuration, or you may not have a final configuration. So, the final configuration is essentially the one in which the state component is halting state. That is how we define. So, and where will be the reading and writing head? It may be somewhere on the tape. So, I may simply write it as, say, since I have used x as for input, let me write some y, some current symbol a z, for some y z in sigma star, and a is the current reading symbol, some, because configuration should be of this form. So, if the halt, if the state component is halting state, we call it as final configuration or halting configuration. We will call it as halting configuration. And now, let me discuss some more situations. For example, the machine, you may be asked, you know, to keep moving to left. For example, from here I have started on this input, and we are moving left, left, left as per the transition. Suppose we have defined the transitions like this. It will come, and there is a, this is left justified tape. Let me call this as the boundary of this tape. So, it will come here. If you are further asked to move to left, what will happen? You are not going to read any symbol, and such a transitions, such a configuration, you cannot actually represent, which is going beyond the tape. I may say that whenever it is coming and hitting this left boundary, I may call it as the machine hangs. So, we call Turing machine hangs if you are asked to, in a particular transition, if you are asked to cross this left boundary in this Turing machine. So, that is called, I may call the situation of hanging. So, hanging situation is that the machine hangs, Turing machine hangs if you are asked to, if a particular transition, you are asked to, means a particular transition is forced the machine to move to left further when it is at the left boundary. That is what is hanging. And of course, one more thing that you can quickly realize is where you will not have this sort of halting configuration, because here in a such a situation, this machine with that particular input cannot have halting configuration, because the machine is hanging. And one more instance is, you know, you may be asked to go to right, in which case you will never come back. So, this is a right side infinite tape. So, you can always find a new cell and so on and so on. And thus, in the situation, it will go to that infinite side. So, you will not have halting configuration, or you can always create on a finite tape, you can go back and forth. For example, the transitions are defined such a way that, for example, if I am here, I may be asked to go to, say, for example, two cells left, and then I may be asked to go to some three cells right, two cells left, three cells right, and so on. For example, if I keep doing this, again you see that you cannot have halting configuration, because two cells left, three cells right. That means, from the current position, finally, I see that I am one cell to right, and in each such loop, I am going one cell to right, and so on. So, in such situation, I cannot have halting configuration. Even if I change this idea that three cells to left, two cells to right, that means, from the current cell, I may go one cell to left, and so on. After some time, it will hit the left boundary, because this is left justified tape. Wherever I am, left to that, there are only finitely many cells. and thus the mission hangs. So, if you do not want the mission to halt, that means if you do not want the halting configuration, you can actually define in two ways. One, making some sort of infinite loop going to the right or oscillating on a finite tape. In such situation, you may say that it is going to infinite loop, or the mission which is touching the left boundary, in which case we may say that the mission hangs. Now, infinite loop. So, these situations I hope now you understand with this. Now, let me give an example for accepting example of a Turing machine accepting this language, a simple language that I consider, that is set of all strings x in over the set a b such that a is a symbol of x. So, that means, a is a substring of x, a is a substring of x. That means, there is an a in x. You see, this is a regular language. We have constructed a finite automaton for this language. Let me construct a Turing machine. As I had mentioned that this is ultimate powerful device. So, what are all the regular languages you can always construct a Turing machine? What are all the contextual languages for which also you can construct a Turing machine? So, this is such a general device that we are introducing, and there is a more general automaton which can accept any of the languages that we have discussed so far, regular languages, contextual languages, etcetera. Now, for this, let us first discuss on this picture, and then corresponding to that we can write the translations. So, the finite control, let me call q naught is the initial state. So, the point is pointing to this. What I do, we start with here, I am leaving one blank here. Now, I keep searching for the symbol a on the tape. So, input is given here, assume input is given here. You come to left in q naught, just to distinguish that you have started, because this is a blank, and after some time you are encountering one more blank if you do not for example, encounter a. So, let me change the state, so that I understand that the computation is started. So, come to left from this blank and change the state for example, to q 1. And now, you see that this particular symbol is a or not in this particular cell. If it is a, then I am happy that there is an a in the input, and simply you change it to halt state, and then the computation completes and that particular input will be accepted. If this is not a, further in that state q 1, you may ask to go to left. In this situation, you need not actually change the state, because state we define in case of automaton to remember something, to create such some sort of memory. Here, I need not remember anything, because the computation started, that is only signal with q 1 I am having. So, if a is there, I am halting. If a is not there, I go on further left and search if a is there, and so on. But only thing is, I have to cross check whether I have encountered this blank, if you do not want to hang the machine. Or you keep going to left, and if it hangs, there is no problem, because if you do not want to accept a string, you can hang it or you can put it in infinite loop. Or if you are searching for this blank, you can search for this blank and you can go to right side further infinite loop. So, in which case, of course, I do not require any new state as well. So, I am in q naught. If I want to hang the machine, I may simply define it like this. So, the symbols are a, b, this is a special symbol always there, I am in q naught. Assume I am at this blank. So, I have to go to left, I will continue in q naught, go to left. If I am encountering b, I will be in q naught and go to left. And if I am encountering a, I will halt it. When you are halting, you may take one cell to left or you may take one cell to right, there is no problem. Or you can print something and halt, maybe some a is there. So, I will same print a. So, this is how if I define delta. Now, you see this quadruple, only one state I have chosen q naught, and sigma is now a b blank, this is always there blank, and delta as defined here, and there is only one state, so this is the initial state, is a Turing machine. And we see the language accepted by, so let me call this as M, since we are calling machines, let me use M. The language accepted by M we see as desired. If I call this as L, this is what is the language. Let us do some computation over this and see like how this is happening. For example, you are given the input, say blank B B A B, for example. So, this is the initial configuration. As earlier with this notation, in one step, let me use this one step relation. So, in Q naught, if you are reading blank, it will be in Q naught, it will change to Q naught and go one cell to left, that is the definition. So, the current state is again Q naught blank B B A B. I am not going to represent this blank now, because the reading leading the right side, these blanks will not be represented in a configuration. So, this is the situation again. Now, in Q naught, as per the definition, if you are reading B, it will go to left, changing to the state Q naught. So, I will continue to the state Q naught, and now this is B B A, this is the current symbol. Of course, this B will be there, we have not changed anything. Now, you look at in Q naught, if you are reading A, you change to halting state and print A. So, at this place, we are printing that, this is overwriting. So, whatever ultimately you write, that will be shown. So, what is shown here? Again A. So, this is the current place, this is the configuration. This is the initial configuration, and now the computation, because this is one step relation I have written, for each transition what is happening, I have updated on this, and see, we have got a halting configuration. And thus, this particular string we say is accepted. If you take a string in which there are only B's, let me take say 2 B's, this is the initial configuration I have to start with. So, what will happen? Since it is reading blank, it will come here B B, and since in Q naught, again it is in Q naught, it will come to this B, and in Q naught again B, so it will come to this place, so B B. And in Q naught, when you are reading blank, it will come to left. So, but coming to left means here is a boundary, so I do not have anything to write here. So, after this, what will what situation will come? I do not have any configuration here. So, this machine hangs here, this machine hangs here. Thus, if you have only B's in a string, that will not be accepted. Let me give you the formal notion of acceptance using this notation. As earlier, the reflexive transitive closure of this one step relation, the one step relation is on the given, so this is over again as usual, we define this is a relation or configuration, the set of configurations. If you apply one transition on a particular configuration to give the another configuration, we say, for example, says this is C and C dash, these two are related by this one step relation. If you can get C dash, the configuration C dash from C by applying one transition. So, this is definition as earlier, and we use this to represent the reflexive transitive closure of this one step relation. And using this, let me define formally, let M be a Turing machine. Language accepted by M, denoted by L of M, is set of all strings in, let me write sigma naught star. So, where M is say Q sigma delta Q naught, as such that you start with this as input, the initial configuration. After finitely many steps, you will get a halting configuration, in which case you may have something on the tape . So, from the initial configuration you get a halting configuration. So, all those strings. So, now what is sigma naught? Because let me write where sigma naught is except this blank symbol. Whatever is the input alphabet, you take this string. So, this is what is formally, let me write the language accepted by the Turing machine M. The language accepted by M, L of M. Now, using this definition, you see that any string which is having A, if you give to this, it will halt once it encounters that particular A. If it is not encountering A, it will keep on going to left, and you see the machine hangs. And thus, only those strings which are having A, at least one A is, if it is existing in the input, on those strings only this Turing machine halts. And thus, the language accepted by M here is L. Now, let me give one more example. The set of all strings, these are all regular languages that we have observed, x in say or a b does not matter, such that it is 2 n for some n. So, all those strings of even length. So, what I have to do here, once again let me discuss with this tape. And then once you are familiar with this, because I am reading from right to left from this side, so then you will be familiarized with. So, the input is given to you. I have to see whether it is of length 2 n or not. As earlier in case of finite automaton, you have two states. In the beginning you will be maintaining, say for example, in Q naught, when you encounter a symbol, you are going to say for example, Q 1, which is understanding, which is recognizing this is an odd length string, and once you read one more symbol, we change it back to Q naught. This is how the finite automaton you have maintained there. Let me write that, so that, so the initial final state is considered to be this. Under all the symbols from this, you may change to say Q 1, and all the symbols you may change back to this if you are reading a symbol here. So, A belongs to sigma for all A in case of finite automaton. So, we follow it this way. The same thing we can write and see. Here I have the symbols A, B, blank and Q naught. Let me start looking at. In the beginning I have a blank. So, I will come to this, the first symbol after reading, then I will change it to say for example, another state. So, to distinguish between this blank and this blank, you can change the state, for example, Q 1 and go to left. And when I am in Q 1, I may encounter B, A or blank, because if this is empty string, I may straight away encounter blank. For example, I am encountering blank in Q 1. That means, this is even length string, and therefore, it should be accepted. So, in Q 1 if I encounter this blank, so I should halt, maybe I will print something or I may take a right move, does not matter. So, this is how you can do. If you are encountering a symbol, say for example, I have encountered A or B, I will count that, now change it to for example, say Q 2. If I am in Q 2, that means, I have read one symbol, you may change the symbol or let me go to left. Similarly, even if I read B in, so let me change to Q 2 and go to left. Now, in Q 2, the meaning of this, I have read one symbol. If you encounter blank, you see this is essentially only one symbol, say odd length here. So, I may ask to go to further, say left, so that it will hang. If I am encountering one more symbol, I will put it back to Q 1. So, Q 1 and go to left. Similarly, say Q1 go to left. And I am not going to encounter A and B in case of Q0. So, I can arbitrarily define anything. So, let me for example, define say Q0 A does not matter because I am not going to encounter as per our convention. So, this is the transition map I have defined here. The states I have considered 3 states here Q0, Q1, Q2. The symbols are A, B blank and the initial state let me declare Q0 as initial state. So, this quadruple accepts, I claim that this quadruple accepts the desired language. What do you do as an exercise? Take various types of inputs, like for example, you take empty string or maybe some string, non-empty string which is of even length, some non-empty string which is of odd length, you take and see the way that I have done the computation, you do it and realize that this accepts this language or the desired language. Now, let us discuss one more example. If you consider, because you know, when I am talking about a substring, because we have seen that when you are reading from, in case of finite automaton, we read from left to right. When I say for example, set of all x in say A B star such that A B is a substring of x. If you consider this example, in case of finite automaton, I see that whether A is encountered, when A is encountered immediately after that whether B is encountered, that we have to see. But as per our convention, since we are coming from right side, first we have to see whether B is encountered, then immediately after that whether A is encountered. This is how we have to design. So, let me do this construction also. Say we have started with the initial state Q0 in the blank. So, on the tape when the input you are coming, let me change to Q1 conventionally and coming to left. If I am encountering yes, I am not worried, I will continue in Q1 going to left, I do not remember these things. Oh, sorry. So, when I am in Q1, if I encounter A, I will continue in Q1 and go to left. But if I got B, then I will remember this. So, that means I will change to Q2 and go to left. If I am in Q2, that means I have encountered one B. So, in the state Q2, if I have encountered some more B's, I can safely continue in Q2 itself. So, that means anyway I have at least one B I have read. Now, after that left to this whether I have A, that is what is important. So, in Q2 if I get A, I can halt now. So, let me print A itself, so that the machine will halt there itself. Now, let us look at the situations. In the Q0, I am not going to encounter this A and B, because in the beginning, in the initial state, I will start with this. I can arbitrarily define anything here, because I have to define, because the transition function is a total map from Q cross sigma. For every state and symbol, I have to define something. Let me write A for the time being. Arbitrarily, I can define anything. So, now in Q1, if you encounter blank, that means in Q1 I encounter blank means I would have so many A's or maybe empty string, because if I have encountered A, I continue in Q1. So, that way the input may be only A's or maybe empty string, in which case I am continuing in Q1. So, in that case I should not accept the string. So, what I do? You can ask it to go to further left, so that it will hang, or you can ask it to go to infinite loop, whatever it is. So, what we do, say let me write Q1 left, it will hang. Now, in Q2, I have encountered blank, if this is the situation. What is the meaning of this? I have encountered a B or so many B's from when I am coming from the right side, but I have not encountered A. So, in which case also the same thing. So, I have encountered blank means I can ask further to go to left, say Q1 left. So, from blank if it goes further, it will hang. So, when or you can define anything here, but it has to hang or go to infinite loop in these situations, that is how we have to define. But here I can define anything arbitrarily. So, where A, we can give, say for example, Q2 B, let me give something I have to give. So, arbitrary. So this and this I may fill with this. Now you, as again as earlier, what do you do? You take the initial configuration with whatever the input that you want to consider and do the computation and see like what are the respective final configuration if they exist. If there is no final configuration, that means either it will hang or it will go to infinite loop, whatever is happening you just observe it and observe that this particular machine accepts this language. And in this lineup maybe some more regular or contextual languages you may try to construct a Turing machine. So, let me give one or two exercises as a homework. Set up all those strings or AB star such that AA is not a substring. So, or there is no consecutive A's, no consecutive A's such that no consecutive A's in A. There are no consecutive A's in X, or you can try this, you know this is a contextual language, A power n, B power n such that say n greater than equal to 1, or you can try, we will discuss some of these things in the next class. X equal to x power r, these are palindromes we have discussed, and whatever is the language I have mentioned, which A power n, B power n, C power n, which is you cannot have pushdown automaton for this, you can try this also. How to remember? Because you know in case of finite automata, how to create the memory and the computation. So, you try these examples, means construct a Turing machine that accepts these things, and we will discuss further on this in the next class.